Hello, Josh Castle here from the Monroe County Public Library. I'm the resident digital media expert, and today I would like to show you how to use the program Gimp to remove a background from an image. The program here, Gimp, is short for the New Image Manipulation Program. And what it is a free and open source alternative to programs like Photoshop. And we can go ahead and download it by going to this download tab here, hitting download here. It should automatically detect your system. So once you're here, you should see a thing here that says show downloads for. So if it's not detecting your system, you can select a specific one. But if you trust it, it says GIMP for Mac OS, which my system is, you can hit download directly and then install. So once you have the program installed, you can go ahead and open it up. I have it down here on my bar. And wait for it to load. Now once this load, you'll see a screen like this. If you've ever seen Photoshop before, this should look somewhat familiar. But if you haven't, you can take a look around at different icons here. There's things like paintbrushes and you know, things that you're really probably familiar with. But there's also different tools like distort and things like that. If you're not sure what something does, I encourage you to test it out and play around. Or you can go to the internet and find lots of very good tutorials on how to use this program. For our case today, I'm going to be opening a pre-existing image. You can also use this to create new images from scratch if you'd like. So I'm going to go to File and Open, and I'm going to find our green screen tutorial file, which I have here. And in this file, we have an image of a guy on a green screen background. Now, I will note a couple things here. So the first thing is that this guy already has a white background around him. And the reason why they've done this is to make it easier for your program, whether that's GIMP or Photoshop or something else, to detect where the green layer is. And what I mean by that is we can do something really quick here by taking the fuzzy select tool. If we click on the green, you can see that it selects around the guy's outline here. And it's really done a pretty good job of detecting where the image stops and from the green to the white. But you can see it's made a little mistake here, which is fine. But really, you can do this to any image. I will say that it works better with something with stark contrast, as I said earlier. And that's because of this very thing right here. So if you're wanting to select a background that was dark or, you know, similar to this guy's face color, you were wanting to remove that background, you'd have a hard time detecting where the background ended and the guy began. But with a little work, you can really make anything capable of removing a background. It's just going to take a longer time. But for this one, this will be a good practice file, which I'll provide a link for. And I'm also going to bring in a background later, so I'm going to provide the link for that too. And I'm just going to go ahead and deselect with Command-Shift-A or Control-Shift-A on Windows to get rid of that. So what we're going to want to do now is add a layer, or go to the layer menu, and then go to transparency, and we're going to add an alpha channel. And this kind of references the different colors that the image is using. So we're going to do that. And then with this fuzzy select tool, which is the tool we used earlier, it's very much like the magic wand tool in Photoshop. And now we're going to select that green again. And I was messing around with this earlier. So the reason why it was so close to this white line is because I messed with the threshold. And what that does is it kind of makes this color detection more or less strict. So the lower it is, the less strict it is. The higher it is, the more strict it is. And I feel like, you know, right now I can zoom out here. And we're going to show, if I go to Edit and then Clear to remove what I've selected, we can zoom in on the guy. And we'll see that there's still the white line, of course. But there's also still these green pixels. I'm not quite happy with that. So I'm going to hit Command-Z or Control-Z on Windows to undo that selection. And I'm just going to bump this threshold here up earlier, during my testing, I determined that 90% was a good file, or 90 was a good level. I don't know if it's actually percentage, but 90 is a good level for in this case. I'm going to hit enter, and then we can just go ahead and reselect the green here. And I'm going to go to edit, and then clear. And now if we look at the guy, we see that there's still some green left, but the colors that are remaining are really the ones that are much closer to white. So we have these really transparent green colors here that are fading into the white, and those really shouldn't be a big problem. So I can deselect again, and then I can look at things like his glasses, and I know that they still have green in there. We probably want to get around this white, or rid of this white here. So let's go ahead and click that. And you can see something here. So what it's done is it's selected this person's face because it's very close to the white color. It's very reflective, it's very white. So what we want to do is lower this threshold. I'm going to do something like 40% and then retest, try to get this white here again. So I'm going to select that. And that looks like it's done a pretty good job. So let me go to edit and clear. And something interesting here is that it's left these pixels here, these green pixels that are kind of like very transparent. But I don't think that's really going to make a big difference in the final product. So let's see if that actually works with the glasses too. And it just so happened to do it. If you find that something doesn't work, so let's say if the transparency was still 90% on this and we clicked in the glasses, we can see the face select again. I just recommend, toying with the transparency and seeing what works for you in whatever specific case. So again, we can go to edit and clear once again. And that's done probably a worse job than what we want. But you know what? I'm just going to say let's keep it. Because I think in the final version of this, you're really not going to be able to see that very well at all. So let's go ahead and get his other green section here, edit and clear. And that one's much better. This actually inspired me to go back and change this one. So I'm going to bump up the threshold a little bit to, let's say 45%. This is just kind of, playing and seeing what works. So let's go to edit and clear that. And see how it works. Oh, that actually looks worse. So maybe a higher value. Command Z again. And let's change this to, I misspoke. Maybe a lower value. Let's do 33% and then select that. And then edit and clear it again. All right. I don't know if that's better, but it's good enough for me. So let's get this one again and edit and clear that. And now if we zoom out, we see our gentleman here, and he doesn't have the white line and he doesn't have a green background anymore. And really, you can't see the issues with his glasses that well either. You could always go in with your eraser tool with different paint brushes or things like that, do some adjustments and remove it. But for this tutorial, we're just gonna take it as it is. So now we wanna add a new layer. So with that, we have this layer as represented in our layer menu on the right here, and that's just our guy here. And we can hide or show that with this little eye here. You can also lock it with different options in here. You can do different adjustments by right-clicking it. But I'm going to add a layer by opening an existing image that I downloaded. And so I'm going to go to File. And I'm not just going to open, I'm actually going to go to open as layers, because if I just opened it, it would open in a new window. But if I open it as a layer, it's going to make it a layer of the specific file. So I'll show you what I mean. Let's go into the files here and I'm going to pull up the image, and I'll take a minute here and let you know that I got this image at unsplash.com. It's a free and open source image hosting platform where everyone that puts their images on there, they release them free of any kind of licensing, for you to use for any purposes you want, any including commercial. So it's a great place to source things to test with, or to kind of like, you know, grow or learn on your own. So I'm going to hit open on that, and it's going to pull it in. This is something, it's talking about the caller profile. We're just going to hit convert. It's a little bit more of an advanced thing, so we're not going to worry about it right now. So it looks like I still have a weird selection thing there. You might have seen a little glowing dot there. But now we have our image into the file. And we can see it because it's on top, and it's the only thing we can see. So how layers work is whatever's on the top kind of takes precedence. So we can go ahead and like hide it, and we can see that, you know, the guy didn't actually go anywhere. Or we can reveal it and, you know, he's gone again. We want him to be in front. So if we remember the idea that he takes press, or that the top image takes precedence, we can do one of two things. We can click and drag the image to the top like so, or if it's on the bottom, we can hit this little arrow key down here, and that raises the layer. You can see this little tool tip here. It says raise the layer one step in this layer stack. And basically that just means put the thing on top. So now we have the guy on top. And really, you can call your day done at this point. We can go in and look at where we made our selection, or where we took out colors, and see this green here. We can hide this layer and then, you know, use our eraser or something like that to get rid of this green coloration if we wanted to. But really, I found that it wasn't very noticeable. You know, if you reveal that color, it's really only when you're zoomed in a lot that you can see it. And I mean, this is something that you kind of have to get a feel for. You know, it depends on like the size or, you know, the scale of the guy. So if we have the image here, we can also move each individual layers. I have the guy's, the man's layer selected. So that's the one I'm gonna move if I try to move anything around. Similarly, I can scale this layer, make him smaller if I want. I don't know why it's showing, it's not. So we have, sorry, something weird just happened there. I'm not sure what that was. But so if we are satisfied with this, we can do one of two things. We can go to File and Export, and export as. We can do different things, like you can do a PNG, a GIF, JPEG, really any kind of file format you want, and hit export. And what that's going to do is just turn it into a file that's done. You don't have to worry about it. It's the finished product that you want. And if you don't need these files ever again, you can just be done with it. However, if you want to come back and edit something, like say maybe you want to say this is a project, or you know that you're going to use these elements again, you can go up to File and save, and if you see this format up here, .xcf, that is the file format that GIMP uses for projects. So if we hit save here, let's go ahead and hit save, and I'm going to close this and go into my file where that is. You'll see the GIMP, little GIMP icon. I'm going to double click that. And now I still have all my files, the different layers and things like that. So if I want to do any further changes, it'd be very easy for me to do so. And that's different from exporting, because once you export, you really don't have that ability any longer. You've kind of locked the layers, so to speak. And speaking of which, say for example, we want this, but we kind of still want to keep it in the GIMP program. Like maybe we're going to want to add stuff, other people to this background or something like that. One thing you can do is go to the topmost layer and right click it, and you can flat merge it down. And what merging it down does is it takes everything and kind of just collapses it. It compresses it into one image. So now we can, you know, bring in other photos, other objects. But this guy here on this background is always going to be in that place, and he's always going to look the same. So you have to keep that in mind if you're going to go this route. You can always undo with Command-Z once again, if you're not happy with anything. But right there, we have a finished product that I think looks pretty good. So there you have it. Now you know how to take an image, remove the background, and add a new background to it using something like a green screen. And I hope that you guys can put it to good use. All right, thanks a lot, and join us next time.